I'm very happy to introduce Dr. Mukta Atrey, who leads the workshop team, and Jaya Gaitonde, who handles our finance. Now I'll request Mukta to make a brief presentation.
Good afternoon, everyone. Now, coming to my presentation today, I'll be talking a little bit about the project itself. We proudly call it Bridging Distances Across India. We have centers from Jammu Kashmir to Kanyakumari to Shillong in the east to Rajkot in the west. So we are really trying to bridge distances across India and bring all of you together, not only in our coordinator workshops, but also in the main workshops where people from different colleges meet at the remote centers and form communities which will propagate learning across the country. Next, please. So the official name for our project is Empowerment of Students and Teachers Through Synchronous and Asynchronous Instruction. You must have noticed that we use teaching, we use the Moodle, we use all kinds of different mediums for the instruction. That's why the title. But over the years, it has been very popularly called the T10KT, the Train 10,000 Teacher Training Program. So we have now stuck to that nomenclature. We started this program in 2009. It was initially, we used the EduSat. But then with the advent of Amrita as a collaborator, we switched to AVU, and we thought that AVU was far more cost effective, as not all colleges had the means of setting up a EduSat infrastructure. Yeah. In 2013, we were asked by MHRD to scale up into the phase two, and that is where IIT Kharagpur came into our partnership. Now we have a partnership with IIT Kharagpur. Professor Datta is here today. And we have a mandate to train 1,50,000 teachers over the next 3 years, and we are going to be doing it through 15 workshops. We will also be conducting several smaller duration workshops, which are not necessarily engineering topics, but several related topics, like how to write, for example, we had done in the past, how to write effective course papers or seminars and things like that. We have conducted 19 workshops till now. This includes all the coordinators' workshops, and I'm counting them from 2009, and yours is the 20th that we are conducting. And we have conducted several core engineering topic workshops, such as thermodynamics, basic electronics, signals and systems with IIT Kharagpur. And we have also done some very special ones, like solar photovoltaics. We were asked by the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, seeing that we have such a reach across the country, they asked us to do a program on photovoltaic research. And also recently we had a program on green building awareness, for which we had a record of almost 13,000 participants across the country. Next, please. So now I come to the methodology. We have several new centers here, representatives of new centers here. So what we do is we identify institutes across the country which have a good infrastructure, who have good faculty who can come as workshop coordinators, whom we can train to sort of embrace our teaching methodology that is practiced in IIT Bombay, and who can then go back and help the main workshop participants. So it's a sort of a dissemination of the IIT philosophy in a nutshell. Now, people at remote centers, these are very important roles. In about 2010, we decided that we'll have a specific person at every remote center called a remote center coordinator who will be unchanging throughout the workshops. The workshop coordinator will change according to the topic that is decided for the workshop, but the remote center coordinator will be in charge of all the logistics, all the official structure, all the rules, nominations, and everything that is necessary to conduct a workshop in a remote center. But the workshop coordinator will be subject specific. He or she will come here for the training, go back, help during, not help, but will play a major role during the main workshop for which he or she has been nominated. But the remote center coordinator remains constant. Now, typically the coordinator's workshop is held, as you can see now, it is held here in IIT Bombay about 2 months in advance. And about the same time, we sort of open the registration for the main workshop so that the coordinators know exactly how many participants, this is roughly, how many participants they would be getting and what kind of preparations they would have to make for their workshops. Then, we use the AVIEW. This is the ICT framework that is developed by Amrita University. They have been our partners and since 2010. And we have been using this particular framework to reach out to all the participants across the country. Yeah, there are several questions about Moodle. We use this learning management system as our main framework for interaction that is offline. For all the teaching material, all the queries that participants ask, or all the assignments. Sometimes we have used them, we have used the Moodle for quizzes as well in the past. So the Moodle is an extremely important framework. I hope that all of you have become familiar with it. In this particular workshop, we may be using the edX platform. Next, please. We may be using the edX platform, but you will be definitely informed in advance about it. Now we come to the main workshop on computer programming. We will be, as Professor Fatak has been telling you, we will be using the mixed mode. So online activity will start on 11th of May. The online activity for the main workshop participants will start, and they will come to your centers between 16th and 21st of June. Now it is up to the, it is the prime duty of workshop coordinators to be monitoring these workshop participants at who have been registered at your workshop, at your center. You will be given non-editing teacher identity on the Moodle, and you will be able to see all the assignments, every activity that your participants are making on the Moodle. So it is in this particular mode, the workshop coordinator's role has been really emphasized to take care of all these activities. Yeah, I've already described what the RCC and the WSC will be doing, but I will also be sending out a detailed note on this just before the main workshop starts to your remote center coordinator and yourself, so that all of you are very clear about your roles in the workshop. You have all been given brochures. Professor Fatak had announced that we will be giving an addendum, and I request my team to distribute the extra page that has been prepared. You have all been given brochures in your registration bags. Please make sure that this slip also is put into that brochure when you distribute the brochures amongst your neighboring colleges. There is also a link to a brochure on the website. If you think you are going to be running out of brochures, please do not hesitate to print, download and print and distribute them. the list of the main workshop participants is already there on the IITB NME ICT website. Registration is still going on. We will be extending by a week. There are several centers where the registration is still very low. As you all know, there is partial funding for the remote centers to host the workshop. My colleagues have already distributed the budget sheet, and my colleague, Mrs. Gaitonde, will be discussing in more detail a little later on. Now, what do you have to do when the participants come to you for the main workshop? They are asked to provide permission letters from their institutes, just as you were. It's your duty to verify that they are who they are, and send us your okay if you know, if you think somebody is dicey or whatever, just send us his or her name and we will make sure that things are taken care of. The short list of the participants will be appearing on the website, as well as we will be sending you an email as soon as the last date is over. That is on 10th. By 10th, you should be having all the names of all your participants. They will also be given your contact details. They will also be given your contact details. The list that we send you has their contact details and email IDs, because since you have to, interact with them well in advance, make sure that everything is there. Even now, the names are being displayed on the website. So make sure that you have all the details of all the participants. It will only make things easier for you. Now, just before the face-to-face interaction, there is rigorous testing with AVU. I have marked it in red specifically, because without AVU testing, without getting the okay from our e-studio team that the audio, video, everything is okay at your end, your center will not be considered for the main workshop. Unless the testing is perfectly done, it will be difficult for us to pass your center to conduct the main workshop. Because as you all know, the crux of the whole project is on good AVU reception. If the professor from IIT Bombay is talking and if your participant cannot hear him or cannot see him, what is the point? I hope you all agree with me there. And make sure that the schedule is rigorously followed. Sajjan Dixit is here. He will circulate a timetable for the main workshop testing. And make sure, as I said, please adhere to it diligently. Now, the Moodle IDs for the participants would have been generated when the registration is confirmed. So we will be sending you those as well. The Creative Commons license and the permission slip, you would have signed it here as well. You have to get it signed from your participants and send it to us later on when you send all the bills and everything. We will be setting up helplines at IIT Bombay for all activities like Moodle, for admin-related problems, for AVU-related problems. Please make sure that you call the correct person. I have had instances of people calling me for AVU-related problems or software-related problems, which, I mean, obviously I cannot help in any way. But make sure you call the right person for the help that you need. The team will always forward you to that person, but there could be delay in your problem getting solved. That is why the care has to be taken. The inaugural and valedictory sessions for the actual face-to-face workshop will be conducted from IIT Bombay, and you are expected to join them. We will be conducting quizzes and solving assignments either through Moodle or edX. Professor Fatah would be able to elaborate on it when we actually get to that. Now, post main workshop, we will be sending you the we will be sending you the certificates of the participants. Now, we have been having a lot of problem with attendance across several centers. All my colleagues, we do make surprise visits. And we have found that this is a huge problem at almost all centers. And one way to check that will be more diligence from the workshop coordinator. Even if it is your own colleague, I think you'll have to be a little bit more strict. And now that we have a mixed mode, assignment submission by the participants is absolutely mandatory. Absolutely mandatory. Without that, we will not give.
Mukta, just one second.
Yes.
This attendance and more than attendance, participation. In the morning only we discussed that physical presence may not mean much unless people put their minds in. But I'll tell you, this has been a very unfortunate experience that there are centers where the attendance is very thin. Now, I understand that in a two-week workshop, particularly when people have other engagements and some examination work or something like that. But I'll tell you two very specific issues. One is, there are a large number of local participants from the same institution. That is natural. When you have 300 remote centers, the local participants will be there. But first and foremost, they are participants of the workshop. At that instance, they are not employees of these institutions working for that institution. Their institutions have agreed that they are being relieved full time to attend this workshop. Let there be absolutely no misunderstanding on this. And sadly, I must say this, in the past, some workshop coordinators themselves have been compliant in such absence. I can understand, though not appreciate, after all it is, let's say, my own colleague from my own department who is a participant. He says, "Arey yaar, jaane to mujhe aaj udhar some exam duty or something kaam karna hai." And unfortunately, that person does that duty for a short time but then disappears. Now, if we don't need such participants, I don't mind if the number 10,000 teachers comes down to as less as 2,000 teachers. But let us make sure that those 2,000 teachers are serious and sincere about what they do. Please understand, it took me 1 year to convince IST to give the IST certificate, which is in this part distance mode, part synchronous. It's not easy. When 35 teachers come to you for a QIP workshop from all over the places, do they absent themselves from the sessions? They don't. Then why is it that just because the main faculty members are somewhere in IIT Bombay or IIT Kharagpur, they do not participate and you don't take it seriously? There are centers where people don't come in time. There are remote centers where the session is supposed to start at 9 o'clock and at 9:15, the center is being actually physically opened because somebody came late. Now, this is where you have to coordinate with your remote center coordinator, who is the primary responsible person for ensuring the other infrastructure. But as far as the attendance and participation of participants is concerned, please tell them this thing on the very first day, even before the inaugural. We have now tried to reduce the total attendance required by you here physically from 2 weeks to 1 week. But the understanding is that for 1 week, you are doing nothing but this workshop. And if you do anything else, you're most welcome, but please do not expect a certificate at the end. Actually, if you waste your time, you are also wasting our time and our resources for bringing you here. So please ensure that this message goes very strictly. And it will be difficult to handle your own colleagues, but you have to do that. Please understand that you are the workshop coordinator. So it doesn't matter how many of your colleagues are participating from your own institution, you are the person in charge. And if they are not listening to you, you have to do one of the two things. Either you have to admit that you cannot be in charge, vacate that place, ask somebody else to be in charge. But more importantly, you have to tackle that situation skillfully. You can't shout at your own colleague. But please tell them in no uncertain terms that unless they attend, they'll not get a certificate. I have seen fancy stuff that happens only with students. You know these signatures, attendance sheet. I have had a sheet which is signed completely and yet a blank classroom when I observe that classroom from here. What is probably not known is that since the video is on, okay, the cameras are on, I can observe each and every classroom from here. Now, what is the point if I receive a workshop attendance sheet which says 27 participants present and I see consistently only three people sitting there, one of whom is the coordinator? Now, this is shameful on our part. And one of us only is abetting this unfortunate occurrence. So please remember, workshop coordinator means you have a responsibility for handling the entire aspect of the workshop, not just the academic, but this attendance part. I will not spend any more time on it, but let us be very clear. Last time, I think Sajjan had introduced this notion that you should take a photograph snap, just a photograph of the classroom. The same equipment that you have, the same camera that you have, take a photograph and upload that photograph. That is attendance. More importantly, tell all participants that such photographs will be taken four times during the sessions at arbitrary point. And IIT Bombay has told us that they shall determine the actual attendance by looking not only at the attendance sheet, but also at these photographs, and also at time to time monitoring with IIT Bombay will be doing independently. Kam se kam itna bolo to sahi, at least tell them. I can understand there will be occasions when somebody has an emergency or something like that, but this callousness with which that is happening. And although I am not parochial, I have never cared for religion, region, etc., etc. I treat all Indians as Indians genuinely. But I will tell you, I have observed this kind of problem more in North India than in South India. I am very sad to say this. So this is a regional imbalance of sort, if you want. The level of commitment, the level of seriousness needs to be improved in every place, particularly in North India. And I have absolutely no hesitation in saying this, because we have statistical evidence of this happening. Now, this is not fair. This is not fair to you, this is not fair to your institution, this is not fair to those handful of people who are taking this seriously. And I think this has to be ensured. So if this has happened in the past, if this happens again, I have absolutely no alternative but to hold workshop coordinator responsible. There is nothing else that I can do. You are my direct representative at that place if I am the teacher in charge here. In IIT Bombay, I am held responsible if there is any hanky-panky in attendance. So you are me, so you will be responsible. Please remember that. I will not stage this anymore, but this has been a single most disturbing point. The advantage that you have now is you have to tell them, look, from 2 weeks, this has now become physical interaction only 1 week. But this also means that you have to monitor their submissions over the earlier 5 weeks. If they don't submit, what do we do? That's a separate matter. We have briefly discussed it. The point is, if they have not made all their submissions in time, they are not entitled to get the 2 week certificate. So that is what is added in the note that has been given to you. Incidentally, the note clearly says now that the teachers who teach this computer programming course are all eligible. These courses are being given, offered not only in engineering colleges and polytechnics, but even in science and commerce colleges. Such teachers are eligible to participate. Because technically I can give them a IST certificate as long as they are teachers. I have the mandate. But tell them these two things, first of all. I will make it clear in my first communication to them online. The second point that was raised, just take 1 more minute, because there is a notion of teaching assistant or teaching associate. So there were several colleagues who mentioned that many of the teaching associates are also teachers and they would like to benefit from this workshop as participants. So my answer to that is, if they think they can benefit from this workshop as participants, let them register as participants. There is no point in depriving them of an opportunity of getting a participation certificate of IST workshop. However, you cannot have them both as participants and teaching assistants. The problem that was raised by some of the colleagues is that if they don't help me in conduct of the workshop as teaching assistants, then I will not be able to conduct the workshop properly because I need their assistance during the lab sessions. Now, I would like to ask you this question. If I am a TA with you and I am also a participant, in the afternoon session, what do you expect me to do? To participate in the group discussion that will happen, to participate in the group activity or the assignment that is happening, or to help you conduct this group activity. You can't do both, no? So is there any solution that people have?
Just want to be the participation in the workshop. So he can, anyway, he is sitting in the classroom. So in the morning session, he can learn the things. And in the afternoon, he can help as well as do the assignment.
The major difference between this workshop and all other workshops, in all other workshops, the learning and teaching starts from day one of the workshop. Here it is starting 1 month ahead.
Oh, no issue, sir. Because at the time of workshop only, I need help of as a teaching assistant. Otherwise, I won't require that much of help in, before the 1 month.
Okay. So,
it is only certification things. That's why the if any teaching assistant want to participate and do not want the certificate, then he can work as a teaching assistant, but he can attend anyway, he is attending.
He cannot. He will not be registered on the Moodle unless he registers as a participant. And therefore, he will not be able to participate in 5 weeks of activity. That's a problem. Okay, here is my suggestion because we want to close this discussion. All the teacher colleagues of yours whom you might have identified as prospective teaching assistants, but whom you and they believe that they will benefit from doing this course as prospective teachers of computer programming, please ask them to register as participants for this course. What is more important is we train maximum number of teachers in the pedagogy and the subject matter for teaching computer programming. That is very important. Now, I agree that this may reduce your strength while conducting the afternoon sessions of your workshop. That is the only time. My suggestion is twofold. Involve some technical people who are not necessarily teachers as your assistants in so far as handling your software and other issues that are there for the labs. Okay. I think if you do that, then it should be possible. That means, please do not involve your teacher colleagues as teacher associates or teaching associates or teaching assistants. Let them register as regular people. Please involve technical staff as teaching colleagues. In those odd cases where you do not have enough technical people and you do require some assistance from some of the colleagues, ask them to do that or provide that over and above their participation in the workshop.
Sir, officially some very good student can be
TA. We have absolutely no problem if you identify final year students or ME students as teaching assistants. Oh, that is absolutely no issue. I had already mentioned it. We routinely do that. In fact, our teaching assistants are always our students. So if you can identify some students who are willing to do that, we pay them some token honorarium, I think 2,500 rupees or something for teaching assistants. We'll be very glad to pay it to these students. Absolutely no problem. By the way, my own observation is some of these students are more enthusiastic even than the teachers. So please feel free to do that. Identify two or three students commensurate with the number of people who register. You will know the number of participants much ahead, so you can plan your TAs. I think this is an excellent solution. In fact, I would go one step forward and suggest that please do not involve colleague teachers as teaching assistants at all. Involve technical staff and students and let all such teachers benefit from the workshop. Believe me, even the expert teachers will benefit. Just as I benefit by learning from Professor Sridhar Iyer the mechanisms to use for modern teaching. All the teachers can benefit. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead, Mukta. Sorry for interrupting.
We have been following this practice of allowing students to act as TAs anyway. In almost all our workshops, we have been doing that. So there's no reason why you shouldn't do it this time.
No. Only thing is we are going one step forward. We are saying try to use only that model. Don't use any other model. Not required. And with some technical staff.
What's the coordinator?
I'm the principal of teaching.
Yeah, he's pointing out a real problem. He's asking me to send a strict note to the principal, coordinator and the principal. They are the people who assign other duties to the participants.
Yeah, that's absolutely. Send a mail that the person who are all getting participated to the particular workshop, they have to be released for the entire period.
Yeah.
That is 1 week in person.
Yeah. That's a good one.
That's a help.
I have letters from principals relieving participants to attend the workshop full time. And there have been centers where not a single participant was there.
At least you can...
I've gone and spoken to principals, showing them the letter.
No, no, what he is saying is, he and I and you cannot do anything about it. So it is the principals who have to be held responsible.
Yes, sir.
I have no mechanism available to ensure accountability of erring principals. The higher you go, the greater responsibility you must discharge, and the greater problem there is for the rest of the world if you don't discharge that response. That's fact of life. But we'll try our best.
So can we make online attendance system for the participants of the main workshop? Rather, this side, sir, your left side.
Yeah, so what is the online attendance system?
Any kind of online attendance for all four sessions, like before tea, after lunch, and after evening tea.
They can
put that.
No, any manual attendance.
It is a good idea, but it is not possible to guarantee that. We have tried Akash tablets, we use it for attendance here. Not all workshop places are such that there are computers in the physical place. The best online thing that we have is the suggestion made by Sajjan Dixit. At the beginning of every session, you take a photograph.
Okay, sir.
That's all. That is online attendance.
Fine.
Also, in the last...
And by the way, before IIT Bombay looks at that photograph, you as workshop coordinator should look at that photograph, no? It's a digital photograph. Yeah, fine. So you can monitor the attendance better. Fine.
Okay,
thank you,
sir.
And also regarding attendance, we expect you to take attendance 4 times a day for all 4 sessions, like exactly like the way we've been doing here. And during the face-to-face, that 1 week, we expect you to upload the attendance sheet at a certain time. Okay? And that is the time when we will be checking through AVU, whether your participants are there or not. So we have 4 slots during the day, and we expect you to take attendance at those times every day. Next. These are our forthcoming workshops. We have a 2-week IST main workshop planned on computer networking, as you all know. And then we also have the workshop, 2-week IST workshop on cybersecurity. This will be in the regular mode of 2-week face-to-face interaction. Registration is already on for that. So please do tell your colleagues who are interested in these topics.
I'm here.
Okay.
And also send a mail that regarding TA.
Yeah, yeah.
That means TAs can be students. That means
yes,
you.
Yes. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, we can involve good students over there rather than that is faculty members.
Yeah, yeah.
We've noted your point. Thanks. We need to send them again.
Functionality of? RC coordinators have a very limited role. They have a role, but they have a role to ensure all the infrastructure. They have a role to ensure that the workshop is conducted properly, that the AVU setup is done properly, etc., etc. I think that has been defined already, isn't it?
And I've already said at the beginning of my presentation that I will be sending a very clear note to remote center coordinator, to the principal, to the workshop coordinator. I'll be sending a clear note with everything very well defined. Thank you very much.
Okay. There is a 2 questions I want to ask. First one, can we take instructors as a TA? Instructor will be having a background of diploma.
I do not understand the term instructor.
No, in the lab instructors, can we make lab instructors as a TAs?
No, what is the qualification of the lab instructor and what
diploma holders? Diploma holders.
Okay, the TA in this particular workshop,
yes,
is someone who is expected to know computer programming.
Yeah, sure.
So if I don't care for the diploma or degree, for example, if I permit a 3rd year or 4th year student, that student does not have any degree also.
Okay, sir.
So that's okay. The okay. Requisite knowledge should be there.
Okay,
so if
sir.
Your lab instructor knows computer programming,
okay.
The lab instructor should not do the following. Suppose I am one participant, yeah. And I tell him, I do not understand how to define this member function in this subclass.
Okay.
He should not ask me, yeah. Who is a class?
Okay. Yes, sir.
As long as he doesn't do that, I'm okay.
Yes, sir. Sir, one more question, sir. And how many TAs are required based on the number of participants?
The number of participants usually define a TA. Normally, for example, I'll tell you in my own institution.
Yeah.
If I have a class which consists of 20 to 30 students, I don't get a TA.
Okay.
If I have a class of 60 students, I get one TA.
Okay.
That is the normal mode. Okay. Now you can take a call on it. We have given already some definition of how many TAs on an average are required. Okay. You take a call. If you have more than 25 participants, you should have one TA. If you have 50 participants, you should have two TAs and like that.
Okay.
And these numbers have been given largely based on what is normally required in the labs.
Okay.
And accordingly the funding.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah, some question here. Yeah.
Sir.
So,
actually the ma'am has said that the mail will be sent to the remote center coordinator as well as principal about the importance of these workshops and what are the rules. At the same time, ma'am, the AVU team is going to check rigorously about the center testing.
Yes.
At the time of testing, you can insist on the remote center coordinator as well as the principal to sit along with the testing time and instruct from your side also, stating that it's mandatory, the rules.
That is very unfair. I cannot ask the principal of an institute to come and sit up in an AVU kind of testing.
But many colleges, remote center coordinator, principals are itself many remote center coordinator. If I talk about our remote center coordinator, is our principal.
I am very uncomfortable with the director or principal of an institution being a remote center coordinator. I am very uncomfortable. I do not know why this should happen, and I do not know why this has happened. If I put myself into the shoes of such a principal or director who is also a remote center coordinator, I have a dilemma. I am supposed to run the institution, not supposed to run the remote center alone. For when the workshop is going on, the remote center during that limited period of 5 days is supposed to spend the entire attention there. If I do that, who will run my institution? So either the institution is so small that there are not enough volunteering faculty members to do that, or there is some other reason. I would not like to speculate on other reasons. But I'll tell you, I am very, very uncomfortable. Okay? So I would request my team to let me know how many remote centers are there where the principals or directors themselves are remote center coordinators. And I would like to write a polite letter to them that we are uncomfortable with this situation. You can continue to complete these workshops, but subsequent workshops, we request you to appoint a coordinator who is an independent faculty member who can devote some time on that. I think that should solve your problem. Currently, we'll have to live with it for some time.
We have
but
done
as
it
I
in
said,
the past, sir.
If the AVU testing requires remote center coordinator to be present, then it doesn't matter whether the remote center coordinator is the principal or anybody. That remote center coordinator, as long as I am fulfilling that role, I have to be present.
Sir,
yeah.
Sir, in the important clarification that we have got today, it's mentioned that applicant should already know C++ and should be teacher for the subject.
Yes.
But as of now, I've realized that in my remote center, some of the participants are such which have some background of C++, but they are not actually teachers of that particular subject, like teachers from EXTC stream or some other stream, and they have already registered. What should be done regarding this?
Session will have to be cancelled.
Okay.
Please understand that this is not a course on learning computer programming using C++. And many of the teachers from other associated departments would not have read the registration registration brochure properly, and they would have said, following topics will be covered. Very good, I would like to learn this. This is not a course on learning programming. We are trying to train teachers who are going to teach programming using C++. So such registrations have no meaning.
So how then they should be cancelled in that case? Like people
I will,
from
HTC. Once they are registered, this modified circular,
yes,
which will now be put up on the website, all the people who have sent in their registrations already will receive an email from my place including some who may be in the process of registering, they might have downloaded the brochure and they are getting the letters, etc., etc. So everybody who registers now and everybody who has registered already will get a short email which says, by the way, we hope you have noted this now.
Hello, good afternoon, everybody. Now we'll see an outline of financial support for the main workshop on computer programming. The whole process can be described in three steps: fund transfers by IIT Bombay, fund utilization, and final settlement, both by remote centers. Now for fund transfers, we require the bank details of all our remote centers. Most of the remote centers have already submitted their bank details, but the new centers will have to provide their bank details. The format for providing bank details is like this: bank name, address of the bank account number, bank account name, IFSC code, and MICR code.
Yeah, this is to be sent by the remote center coordinator, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So you have to get this information back to them and ask them to ensure that they do this.
So the new centers only. Huh? Sorry?
Online.
Yeah. We will send the instructions how to upload online. It has to be uploaded online on our website. Now the details have to be absolutely accurate. If there is a missing digit in the account number or a digit is wrong, the bank transfer will not go through. So it has to be absolutely accurate. Please note that the bank account has to be an official bank account of your institute. It should not be in any personal name. The bank details given by you will be considered as authentic. IIT Bombay will not be responsible for its authenticity of your bank details or any discrepancies arising out of it. We will start the bank transfers immediately after the registration is closed, and we will complete them before the main workshop starts. Now the RCC and the institute head will receive an auto-generated mail confirming the amount and the date of credit. Now we come to the next step, that is the fund utilization. Funds utilization has to be strictly as per our sanctioned budget and the utilization guidelines provided by us. Now you can refer to the budget sheet, the copy is given to you. The budget sheet is self-explanatory. It is in two parts, a fixed cost and a variable cost. Under fixed cost, we have subheads, honorarium to your team members, miscellaneous expense budget, and institute expense budget. Honorarium has to be transferred to your bank accounts and it should not be paid by cash. Miscellaneous expense budget is given for the registration kits to be purchased for your participants, stationery, postage, printing, photocopy charges, chartered accountant fees, and other workshop related expenses. Institute expense budget is ₹6,000 per RC. This amount has to be transferred to your institute account for the common facilities provided by your institute, such as infrastructure, electricity, telephones to be used for the workshop. The next part of the budget is variable cost. Under variable cost, we have food, accommodation, and travel reimbursement to the participants. All RCs will have to arrange lunch and tea twice a day for their participants and also to their team members. Accommodation has to be arranged for outstation participants. Travel reimbursement is also for outstation participants. The criteria for TA reimbursement is that the distance between the participants' institute to the remote center has to be more than 100 kilometers one way. Each remote center will calculate their own variable cost as per their number of participants. Thus, the total workshop cost per RC will be their fixed cost entitlement as per the budget sheet plus the actual variable cost. Now we come to the third step, that is the final settlement. This is a post-workshop activity. After the workshop is over, all remote centers will prepare final settlement in the documents provided by IIT Bombay. There will be two main documents, grant utilization certificate and receipt and payment statement. Both these documents have to be printed on your institute letterhead and they are to be signed by both the coordinators, that is the RCC and WSC. The final settlement has to be certified by a chartered accountant. CA certification is mandatory, and this is our audit requirement. Final settlement documents along with all the original bills have to be submitted within 1 month after the workshop gets over. The certificates of RCC and workshop coordinator will be released only after the final settlement is complete. This finishes the outline of our financial process. The budget with utilization guidelines in details and final settlement documents, the formats will be mailed to you well in advance before the main workshop starts. We will also be available on mails and phones for your doubts and queries. Thank you, and my best wishes for the main workshop.
Just a couple of things very quickly. This is exactly in line with the previous standard budgets that we have approved. There is one major change that we have made. Please remember, all other workshops were 2-week durations. This time the physical duration is less. Physical duration is only of 1 week. What we have done is, we have reduced the honorarium to be paid to remote center coordinator and the TAs who will work only for that particular duration. But we have retained the honorarium for the workshop coordinators who are now required to monitor the participants' work for the first 5 weeks as well. 1 day a week they will have to spend. So that is the reason for it. Somebody in your remote centers, particularly the RC coordinator, and particularly if the RC coordinator is your director also, may ask you this question. So please explain to them that this is what Professor Fatak explained, that the work for the workshop coordinator is not reduced by doing this mixed mode thing. Workshop coordinators are still required to do 2 weeks equivalent of work. The only work that is reduced is the RC coordinator and the TS. Otherwise, there is no difference. This is as per the standard thing that we had worked out on. Is that okay? There was some question on the accommodation. 350 rupees.
In our guest house, we need to pay per head
350.
Our budget is 175. Our budget is 175. Which is this place, I say? Oh, NIT Trichy. Is there nearby? No, but you can't get in Trichy anything cheaper than 350 rupees.
So we can charge, no, to the participant.
So then we have already stated on our website that the accommodation will be based on availability. So what we can do is, once they register, you should tell them that they will have to pay this difference extra. See, we have to, as I mentioned earlier, Mr. Ashok Thakur, Secretary MHRD, himself has told me time and again that you have to move towards a self-sustainable model. Now, how do we make it self-sustainable unless the participating teachers are willing to pay the cost of the entire workshop? The entire workshop cost is too much, but the small amount, will they be willing to pay? Yeah.
When our institute audit comes, he asks the bill. Because he already certified one particular thing, and he asked the original. Because last workshop, this was a problem. We convinced them a little bit and sent you the original bill. But there is a problem. Once it is certified, audit was happened at the institute level. We need an original bill because that auditor.
But yeah,
you
can show them our guidelines that we need original bills.
You see, you are spending money from our budget. You are not spending money from your budget.
But it was already done, sir. Because our same chartered accountant was doing the audit. So he said that, okay, I have already done the audit. So either we can send you the Xerox, again we have to convince, because every time we have to convince him.
The same auditor is doing the...
No, but this is a genuine problem. Our audit requires original bill because it is from our funding, and as per GFR, my Dean R&D's office needs to maintain all these original receipts. We will take this offline, but I really do not know what the answer is. The best bet is our auditor and your auditor sit down together and discuss it. It is beyond our... It is beyond our domain of expertise. That's a fact of life. All right.
No, you send the bill, send the CA certified, no? First you get it, first you get it certified by CA, and then you send the bills to us.
Yes, that is okay, but that's why my CA says that I've already done this certification. So it needs to be comes in the college account. So we need the bill. Because again, everything will be submitted to my parent institution also, because there is an interception
app.
So last year what we done, we taken colored xerox of that and we kept it.
You don't take a color Xerox, you scan the original bill and print as many originals as you want. Okay. Yeah.
No. Can I have two TAs for 50 participants and pay them 5,000 each?
No, the TA payment unfortunately is as per the decision.
It is one TA per 15 students.
It is one TA per 15 students. So we have said 2,500 rupees per TA. What you are saying is you want less number of TAs, but you want to pay them more.
No, I am asking whether I can pay them 5,000 each if two good persons are available, or I will have to arrange four persons.
If you have 46 to 60 participants, our guidelines say that you can appoint four TAs.
Yes.
But you pay them 2,500 rupees each.
That is upper limit.
That is the upper limit that is decided by a whole lot of conventions. See, it's very difficult. Individual institutions will have different rules.
Okay.
For example, his Trichy Institute charged 350 rupees for a stay.
Yes.
So if there is any extra payment that has to be made, let your institution pay that.
Okay, okay.
Yeah. From this budget, we'll not be able to.
But I should appoint person. If
sir,
I
want more. Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, what he is asking is, use the same 10,000 rupees budget, but I don't need four TAs, we need only two TAs. That will not be possible. No, that will not be possible. Yeah.
Hello,
any other question?
Sir, here.
Yeah.
Sir,
yeah, please.
Without honorarium, some students are interested to voluntarily, they want to work as a TA. And the previous class you told that yes, they might be allowed to register as a TA.
Very happy. Let them.
Especially M.Tech students, they are helping us in other C programming class, laboratories and other things, sir.
To say that these TAs have worked in an honorary capacity, absolutely no problem. We'll acknowledge, I'll write a special letter to them. You return the money that is given to you. No issue.
Hello, sir. Left side, sir.
One more, sir.
Sir, previously rupees 20,000 has been given as an honorarium for the person who is acting as both RCC and WSC. So what is the revised amount for the person?
As I said, just as I am very uncomfortable with the principals and directors being the remote center coordinators, I am also not very comfortable with the remote center coordinators themselves being workshop coordinators as well. If this happens in one or two courses, which is the area of the specialization of the remote center coordinator, I can understand that. If that happens, we will take a call. I have asked them to put all such things on hold. That I will decide. But I presume that such remote center coordinator who is keen on working as a workshop coordinator also, he or she is not working for the sake of honorarium. So it doesn't matter what that amount is. I will take a call myself. End of the matter.
Sir.
Right.
Sir, one more thing, sir. Sir, you have mentioned teaching associate and teaching assistant.
No. That terminology was merely because at that point in time, we felt that there will be colleague teachers who will be helping. And if that happens, the name teaching assistant does not look good. That's the reason I had used the name teaching associate.
Totally
it is
fine,
in
sir.
The same sense that if I am teaching computer programming for 10,000 teachers here, you are all my teaching associates. You are not assistants in any which way. But now you understand the importance of your role because you are the deliverers of that course for all the participants there. The other TAs may not understand, that is why I had used this term. That is all defunct now. As we have agreed, we will have only teaching assistants who are either technical people like diploma holders who understand computer programming or our students. We will not have teachers as our teaching assistants or teaching associates at all.
Okay, fine, sir.
If they wish, they can benefit from the course by becoming participants.
Are they going to work for 1 week physical hours or
yeah,
2 weeks?
Yeah, 1 week only, no?
Only 1 week.
Yeah, yeah.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, last question.
Yeah.
Sir, here.
Yeah.
Sir, can a participant act as a AVU coordinator also?
if he has been involved in setting up AVU since the beginning.
AVU coordinator has a full-time activity during the workshop. That person has no business attending the course. Okay, thank you very much.